Nintendo presents, Retro Studios presents, Dolby presents the sound, PkGam presents the commentary. Hello everyone, welcome to another random gameplay here. I was thinking about switching from Zelda to playing another game. Just because I like to keep up the variety on my channel. I know I intended Twilight Princess to be like a summer project of sorts, but... I don't need to save. I'm not using any memory cards, I'm not keeping this save file in the slightest. But anyway, I tried to make my channel a variety gaming channel by playing my favorite games, which often tend to be mainstream games, as well as rare or unknown games, and I'd like to kind of switch it up every once in a while and not just stick with one game for months upon months, because I'm nowhere near close to finishing Twilight Princess. People in the comments are probably gonna be like, no, he's never going to finish it. No, well, stop being over dramatic, because I will finish it one day. It just that there's no like ultra high priority to continuously stick with one game per se, because of the fact that I feel it would get kind of bland after a while, and I don't want that to happen, so I want to mix things up. So I'm gonna start by doing a random gameplay here. I'll probably start some other walkthrough and then go back to Twilight Princess after I finish that walkthrough, or like switch between two walkthroughs at the same time or something like that. Anyway, here comes the entrance to our famous bounty hunter girl. Well, eventually, once she manages to land her ship. She seems to be kind of flopping around there. Ah, there we go. Samus Aran.
Woo!
I'm just going to be going through this first space station area here in this random gameplay, just to give you a taste of this game. I love Metroid games, and especially the Metroid Prime games. I'm not typically a fan of first-person shooter games, because they're all, well, not all of them, but most of them are just like generic first-person shooter number 169 or something like that. So they don't really offer too much difference between each other, and that's kind of the reason why I stray from first-person shooter games. Anyway, you press the L button to lock on the stuff, press the B button to jump, A button to shoot, hold the A button to charge a shot. You'll notice that there's barriers around the edges here so you can't fall off. That's a nice little touch. And if you switch to your scan visor by using the D-pad, you can see down there at the bottom left corner that cross there represents the D-pad. So if you press left, you go to the scan visor, scan with the L button. And these switches, you gotta put them online. And this is the time where you're going to have to use the R button to go and look around to shoot the switches. I'm just going to shoot them kind of lazily. But it works out nonetheless. You gotta jump up the gap. And I'm gonna fall off the edge. Woo! No, it's not gonna happen. As I said, it's a nice touch because this is a beginner area. It's like a tutorial of sorts. So you can't just like, woo, right off the edge like so. And yeah, it's a... my visor got steamed up. Oh, and I'd love to do a walkthrough on this game, but these scans are what really give you the 100% status in the game. Well, aside from all the equipment and stuff like that, but these scans are absolutely obnoxious. There's hundreds, if not thousands of them in the entire game. This is how the game tells the story, by the way, is through these scans. And also, you have to scan both sides of every door, and yeah, it's just... That's the only problem that I have with the Metroid Prime games, is that if you want to 100% them, they're just... And you can miss some scans, too, like permanently miss them. Here's a little critter over here. Ugh! And what does this do? Oh, I gotta repressurize the thingy and Surprisingly, despite being in a no-gravity area, you're able to walk on the ground. Maybe you have magnetic boots or something like that. Let's move on. I'm not going to obsessively scan stuff here. I'm just going to give you a taste of why I think it would be a bad idea to give a walkthrough on this game, unless I really, really know where everything is. Like, whoops, I didn't show all that text. Now, just watch how many scans are in this room. Here's a couple scans right here. Here's another one. Now, oops, now all these enemies here. This is a space pirate, by the way. And, yeah, that'll do it, for sure. And here's a ginormous monster here. It looks like there is some sort of battle, which explains the distress signal that was going around over here. This is what I mean about the scans telling the story of the game. And, yeah, that'll do it as well. There's another scan over here. And just imagine having to do a walkthrough on this. Like, and just imagine if I were to miss some of these scans. How would I remember, how would I know which scans I got and which ones that I didn't, you know? That sort of thing. And I already got that one. Here's another scan. It looks like there's two more below that. You can see where the scans are based on the glowing symbols, those square things like that. And if you got the square things before, they will appear as a translucent square. Where did that other one go to? Oh, whatever. Guess it doesn't really matter now. There's another four things to scan over there. So, it's still alive, huh? Not for long! And you can also scan these things, which is also necessary. These recover your energy. Your energy is your life at the top of the screen there. More stuff to scan! And, yeah, I just don't think that this would be something that would be fun to watch as a walkthrough. I mean, if you're going to make a walkthrough on it, it wouldn't be for, like, for the sheer fun of watching it or for the making of it. It would be pure business, and that wouldn't be very fun to do. Now, this stuff over here, you gotta break by doing a charge shot. But there's another thing here that you can scan. Oh, and I also forgot to scan the doors, but, But I think you're getting the idea of this now. Anyway, charge up your shot by holding the A button, and there's this guy here. He just doesn't really do anything there. He's just dead, poor thing. And now there's a little hint of what you can do here. You can go into this corridor by pressing the X button and turning into a ball. Whee! And scooting yourself in here, of which you can find a whole load of more scans. Like, you can scan this map system before you grab it. But when you go in here, you got an entirely different set of thing that, I mean, a thing that you have to do. This is like the dungeon map in Zelda games. What sets Metroid games apart from other FPS games is the fact that they're more like adventure games than they are FPS games, and that's why I like them more than any other FPS. As I said, other FPSs, very, very generic. You can move around on your map with the C-stick, zoom with the L and R buttons, but I'm not going to... Well, I'll show it to L button, zoom out, R button, zoom in. And as you can see, our path is eventually going to go back over to there, but I'm going to leave and watch how many things just in this room you can scan. And of course, this is going to tell you more about the story of the game, like there's a parasitic infestation. That does not sound good in the slightest, but we can't get there right away. We gotta scan more things. So, yeah, I mean, I would love to make a walkthrough on this game, but I just would not have the tolerance to 100% it. I mean, I suppose I could show her all the, you know, like, all the equipment and stuff that you can collect and stuff like that is, but, oh, all these scans are ridiculous, and, you know, I would also have to show the little text that goes along with it, you know, to tell the story of the game. And you gotta scan both sides of the door! scan this, but actually this is required to progress in the game. It's a little cutscene activation here, just going to the hologram. Boop! Oh wait, actually, oh, I forgot to scan it before I... platform active. Yes, I knew that! But I had to scan it anyway for 100%! Actually, I'm not sure if you need to scan all the stuff in this first area to get 100%, because of the fact that You can't get back here later on in the game. That's kind of a bummer, because this area is pretty cool. But I suppose there's nothing for you after you leave this area anyway. Wait for the electrical field, well, the electricity to go away, and scuttle your way through here. Don't forget to scan the door! And don't forget to scan the door from the other side! I think you're getting the idea of it now. Also, there's all these things to scan. All these orange things on the wall, these holographic display panels. And there's also an enemy coming up here. I should get out of here and duck around the corner before it sees me. And this one here is going to attack you, I believe. It's on the ground because something happened to it. Yeah, it's broke, but it's not dead. At least not till I got to it. Look at all the stuff you have to scan on this board as well. It's just so obnoxious, and all the Metroid Prime games are just like that. There has to be thousands of scans throughout the game. I mean, just look how much time I'm spending just scanning this stuff here. Did I get everything? Just want to make sure. Actually, it doesn't really matter if I get everything. This isn't a save file I'm keeping anyway, as I said. What did I see that I was able to... Oh, that was the thing I could scan. Okie dokie. Is that something that I could shoot for the fun of it? No, I guess not. I could shoot the doors to open them. I guess that's sort of fun. Another display panel to scan. Something that fell, which is kind of spooky, but I have no idea. There's something going on around us. Wait, where'd that come from? I didn't see... Oh, security thingy. Security system. It's working against me, dang it. It certainly did not stop this invasion. Alright, what else do we have to scan in here? Oh, good lord. Oh, I'm done. Let's just move on here. Oh, no. Yeah, I do not want to waste that much time scanning stuff, especially when this is a primarily action-adventure game. Alright, definitely have to scan this, though. It's a elevator operational. I don't have to scan this, do I? No, I don't. Boop! But surprisingly, despite it saying platform active or elevator active just like the other one, it you still have to scan it for that 100%. The scans are handy to a point in that you can use them to find the weaknesses of enemies and stuff like that. And, by the way, lock onto enemies with the L button, it's kind of like L-targeting in Zelda games. The Prime series here shares a lot in common with Zelda games being an adventure game, as like hybrided into a first-person shooter game. I bet you I could scan some of the stuff on the wall. Oh my god! Two things just on that wall alone. What's this? Oh shoot, I didn't notice that. And I'm going to shoot you down. Or I can scan you by mistake. I'm pretty quick with my thumb, by the way. The ladies like it. I think that's all I'm going to do there. As I said, I'm not going to waste more time with scans, but I will take a look around here just for the fun of it as we go. You can see a very nice elevator, a sequence going on here. It's almost... Ugh, surprise attack, huh? 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 Is there anything that shoots on the ground? I guess not. I think I'm going to have to go into ball form here. Please insert metallic sphere. A metallic sphere is the thing that opens. Oh, and also drop a bomb here. And there we go. It should release me eventually. There. How many scans in this room? Actually, I should kill these things off first. No. Curses! Will I have to go back? Yes, I will. Duh! Shouldn't have left the room. Boop. Come on, open faster. Should have just stayed in that room like a man. Or a woman in this case. No! Do not kick me out of the room! I'm not very good at first-person shooter games, though I am fast at the draw. It's just that I don't have the strategy for them. Oh my god, how much is there to scan? Well, yeah, Dad, there's two turrets. I barely could get through the door. Well, because they push you right out of the door. Boop. Open says me. Come on, come on, come on. Go, 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 go. I don't have all day. Well, all night, as the case may be. It's like 1 in the morning right now. Boss battle time. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, that's not the music at all. I'm just trying to be dramatic. Being the first boss of the game, it's pretty dang easy. I will scan it for the fun of it. And this is... It takes a while to scan it, too, by the way. Parasite Queen! You gotta shoot in between the protective force field. And, yeah, that's pretty much it, really. And it can shoot at you, of course. I mean, it's guns versus guns. Alright, back to normal mode. Like, you can't shoot through that whatsoever, as you can tell. And you can jump towards the side by pressing the B button, which is very handy, to strafe to the side while you're locked on. Again, it's another thing that's a lot like Zelda. Very, very handy to dodge its attacks. Come on, open up. There we go. I needed the force field to be open before I could do anything. Perhaps I should be doing charge shots? Maybe. Woo! So, we're basically on the scaffolding, and you can't really fall off all that easily. In fact, I'm not even sure you can fall off at all, because it never even happened to me. But it's like a circle around the area, and that's the battle arena. Very, very, very easy boss. You can even tell when it's about to shoot, because it opens its mouth and that green fire starts up. It's about to shoot its lasers. You suck! And the force field out of this place opens up. And evacuate! Evacuate! Problem! Apparently that thing was keeping this thing stable or something like that. I don't know, but we gotta move! Even though we still have loads upon loads of stuff to scan. Actually, this, you can't scan, strangely. Maybe it's because they're focusing on the escape aspect of it. And hologram, hologram. Yes, there we go. You see at the timer there at the bottom of the screen, that's how much time you have to get out. I believe you go like this. Or not. I was just looking at the map. I wasn't exactly sure which direction I had to go. They give you plenty of time to get through here. And why am I even bothering to scan that? I don't know. I guess it's just because I had my scanner out. Wally poopers! I guess if I wasn't there, they would have been taken care of anyway due to the explosion of death. Anyway, you want to climb up this now broken area. And strafe around here. And wait. Sneaky, sneaky. You'll never, ever die in this area unless you're really, really bad, even though I'm playing really reckless. It's just because it's a beginner's area, and the guys do not make you take too much damage. Remember that vent that was that I couldn't shoot earlier? Yeah. And now it's opened up, and I can go through here. I believe it's faster to roll than it is just walking normally. That didn't cause me any damage whatsoever. Interesting. I would think that those bugs that essentially are suicidal would be more threatening. I'm switching between the L and A buttons there to keep locking on and killing off multiple critters at one time, in case you didn't realize what I was doing there. But as I said, I just don't have the strategy of first-person shooter games to be really good at them. I'm sure I could be if I played them more, but... As I said, first-person shooter games are not a genre I like because they don't do much to set themselves apart from other genres, except for the Metroid Prime games, as I said. So anyway, we're still escaping here. It's pretty awesome, and we still have plenty of time. I'll probably be out of here by the 3-minute mark, actually. Wait. I forgot. Oh, there we go. I was gonna say, those things don't open on my own. I mean, I can't open them. Alright, moving on. There's more of these critters, but they aren't doing much of anything, dang it. They're just there to be, I don't know, give the place more life, I suppose. Kill off the turrets. Why is the security system going after humans anyway? Maybe you can't tell I'm a human because I'm in the Varia suit or whatnot. And more of these. I'm just going to walk through them. Oh, they do cause damage when you're not in ball form. Never noticed that before. Not enough, though, as you can tell. As I said, beginner area. I only did like a couple points of damage. Open says me. Come on! Ooh, this is rather hot. I'm going to go. Wait, wrong way, isn't it? Yeah, I have to go that way. I'm gonna wait for that piston to go through again. Else it's not going to. Oh, it is. Oh, push me a little. Okay, I'm gonna follow it this way. You would think that this would be kind of hot, but maybe your suit protects her good enough. But I know there's certain areas that are far too hot for her suit. And is there... I'm just curious, is there more stuff to scan even on this... No, I guess not. On this race to escape. What if I were to look up at the ceiling there? Uh-oh. It's Ridley! Bring it on! Come back here and fight me like a dragon! Dinosaur thing, whatever the heck it is. So anyway, you gotta look up. Well, get out of your first person mode there. Lock on, let go, lock on, let go. You just do that with the L button, it'll happen automatically. It's just so very intuitive. They do such a great job of doing the platforming in this particular first person shooter game here. Platforming or jumping in first person shooter games usually suck horribly just because you can't see what you're doing, but they just do such a good job of it. And I don't know how they managed to do that, but they did. Anyway, event occurs, explosions, oh! And your suit will never be the same. Yeah, this is how Samus in this particular game loses her equipment. She loses it every single game, dang it. And they have a different explanation for it each time as well. Kudos for them for managing to do that. So now we're defenseless. Well, sort of. Still not all that defenseless. We still got our guns and stuff like that. We're just gonna sneak our way through here. And I've been wasting a lot of time, haven't I? Because I expected to be out of here through the 3-minute mark, actually. Wait, am I? Oh, what? Was that? I didn't notice that before. What? Oh! Oh, that's, I guess that's why. There we go. Open! Ah. As you notice, as I said, I've been really, really messing around here. Can I see these things scan? At least it looks like they were scannable at one time. And we're back outside! Or maybe that's the things that I scanned out as I was coming in. And despite the timer still having a bunch of minutes left, you still make it out in the nick of time. Awesome Ridley music playing, by the way. Classic theme. And that's all I'm going to be doing in this random gameplay. Well, at least until the cutscene ends. So I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you later.